Hi folks, and welcome to another video. Apologies, I've actually got bronchitis at the moment, so my voice is a little bit in and out, so apologies for that. Anyway, today's trip, I'm really looking forward to today's trip because today we're out with not one, but two Ineos Grenadiers. Stick with us. We all met in Oswestry, and this was to be my first look at the Grenadier in the metal. It's a good looking vehicle. After some introductions and a brief look round the vehicles, it was on to the first lane. Vehicles out with us today are two Grenadiers, obviously, both a petrol and a diesel. A Defender 110 Puma, a Td5 Discovery 2, and our own Td5 Defender 90. Vegetation's pretty soft here, so it's not going to cause any problems. From here, we headed to Corwin. Okay, so here we are at Corwin Car Wash. Mark's the first one to go across in the diesel Grenadier.
Next, the petrol Grenadier. Ineos ball in his very tidy 110. And now Callum in his disco 2. Lastly, the Lane Structure Trails Defender 90. We need to go back to pick up Ben.
Belly up the wheels. Belly up the wheels.
we stopped for lunch, which gave me a good chance to have a look around the Grenadier. Okay, starting with the interior, I was quite surprised at just how nice the interior is on the Grenadier. The steering wheel felt nice in the hand, and compared to the large wheel in the Defender, it was nice, small, compact, unobtrusive. The switchgear seemed to be well thought out, with everyday road buyer stuff being low down, off-road stuff being higher up, cockpit style. The twin sunroofs also made the vehicle feel light and airy. Okay, moving on to the exterior. I think the Grenadier is a really good looking vehicle. It actually looks a lot better in the metal than it does in the photographs. Ineos claim that the Grenadier has roughly 264mm or 10.4 inches of ground clearance. That's roughly about the same as what I have underneath my Defender. Looking at the two vehicles, the Grenadier does seem a little bit more cluttered than the Defender does, so I think you'd be a little bit more likely to ground in the Grenadier than you would, say, my Defender, but that's just my opinion. From what I've seen of it, personally I think the Grenadier is a fantastic vehicle, and if I was in the market for a brand new four-wheel drive, it would certainly be in the running. In fact, for me, it would probably be a toss-up between this and a Jeep Rubicon. Anyway, that's enough from me. Back to the lanes.
Cheers, thank you. Yo. Cheers, man. Quite a picturesque stretch of lane, this. If this was open or shut?
It's broke, to be honest.
Huh?
It's broke anyway, to be fair. Does this gate need shutting or?
No, it's like that when we came through, just leave it.
Okay, then.
I'll pull down a bit for me. Just stand up. You know where this is, don't you?
What's that?
This is where Rich broke down.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. But we came from up there.
I don't recognise it, to be honest.
No, I didn't at first, and I thought...
If you are interested in buying a Grenadier, Mark Godbold at JT Used Telford is the man to see. Mark's out with us today. He's the gent in the blue Grenadier, and he also organised this trip. Thanks for the invite, Mark. Thank you.
with a good pitch.
Oh, it's only coming down.
Okay, yeah.
In a bit, but he looks like a woman when he's got over it.
Okay, that's almost all we've got time for. We hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, please consider leaving a like, comment, subscribing, sharing, any of that wonderful stuff. It helps us out enormously. And as always, thanks for watching.